Greetings, welcome to Machine versus Mathematics channel. Here we have one of the simplest questions asked in JEE Mains 2005. Okay, circuit analysis. Best question is this. See, two sources of equal EMF are connected to an external resistance capital R. The internal resistances of the two sources are R1 and R2. If the potential difference across the source having a resistance R2 is zero, then you have four options. Okay. Now this is very simple to solve. Let us separate this problem, or let us divide this problem into two parts, ideal case and practical case. Two sources of equal EMF. EMF means what? Electromotive force or rising voltage or the voltage source which is supplying energy, say. Okay. So that's the meaning of C. Always we have rising voltage and potential drop. Okay. See, whenever you have rising voltage, current always flow from minus to plus through that voltage source. Okay. Whenever we have potential drop, that means through that element, current always flows from plus to minus. So this is very simple to observe. Okay. So anyways, two sources of equal EMF are connected to an resistance R. Let me take a case like this. I have a DC source. This is my EMF source 1. And let me take one more like this. Now see, these two are connected in series, and this one and this connection, and across this terminal, say two terminals, we have a resistor R. This is given to you, two sources of equal EMF. That means, say, if it is, let me say, this is V1 and this is V2. Okay. So voltage source 1, V1, and voltage source 2, V2. So now he is given that two sources of equal EMF. That means, let me say that V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V. All right. Or you can take E, capital E, whichever is comfortable, you can go with it. Okay. It doesn't matter. Now these two are EMF sources. That means current has to go this way from minus to plus, right? So current is C coming out of this terminal. This is plus, this is minus, this is plus, this is minus. Whenever we have source, current has to go this way from minus to plus. Okay. And now this current is going all the way down the circuit. Now always current enter at plus and leave at minus. This is always. Now this indicates you have, you know, something is absorbing. When something is entering at plus, leaving at minus, this indicates something is absorbing. This resistor fellow will absorb and dissipate things in the form of heat. Okay. So therefore across this R we can find voltage drop. See, this is what voltage rising. This is what voltage rise. This is what voltage rise. So therefore we could say you have these two active sources. But in this case, what happens, say current I is flowing around the circuit like this, okay, or through the circuit current is flowing this way. Now what is the voltage across this? I into R. Yeah, I into R is voltage drop across this, because current entering at plus, leaving at minus. But now this is ideal case. Now in ideal case, the internal resistance of these voltage sources are zero. Okay, so in practical case, what do you have? In practical case, we can redraw this circuit like this. Each and every C, for example, if I take this voltage source V1, let me take voltage source V1. Now I have to take a series resistance. Now let me, because a practical voltage source will always have this internal resistance like this. Okay. So in series, similarly, what I do, let me take one more. I have voltage source V2 now. So again, in series to this voltage source V2, I have its corresponding internal resistance. Okay. Now this combination is connected across a resistor. This is my external resistor. Okay, given to you like this. Now this, in this question, you must take this circuit. Okay, I just want to show a difference between ideal and practical cases. So therefore, this is my V1 and this is my V2. So internal resistance of V1 is this R1 and internal resistance of V2 is this R2. Okay, so these two are connected in series like this. All right, now again R1 and R2 all are in series. Okay, R1, R2, R, these three components are also in series. And R1, R2, R, these are passive components. Passive means what? The meaning of passive is absorbing. The meaning of passive is it depends on somebody. For example, your parents are active sources and you are passive components because you depend on them. Okay, simply passive means to consume or to absorb. Okay, always that you have to always mind it. Okay, so anyways, so you have things like this. So as these are my sources, current has to come out of positive terminal. So current is going all the way and is like this, say I. Now what is given to you? The internal resistance of the two sources are R1 and R2. And he mentioned that this fellow R2 is greater than this fellow R1. Now if the potential difference across the source having resistance, internal resistance R2 is zero. That means across this fellow. Yeah, if the potential difference across the source having resistance R2, so this fellow is having resistance R2 as internal quantity. So across this, yeah, you have potential difference zero. Yeah, you have what? We have potential difference as zero. So we could take something, this one as say, this one, let me take it is Vx equal to zero. Okay, and anyways, we have equal EMF sources or equal voltage sources. So therefore, we could say let V2 equal to V1 equal to V. Let V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V. So now what do you do? Now there is no big deal in this. You can check it out. See, you just apply, say for example, now the voltage, the potential difference across this V2 along with this R2 is say Vx and that is equal to 0. So therefore, I can write it down like this. Now this V2 is equal to V. So therefore, V minus R2 multiplied by this current. See, this current is coming all the way, entering at negative, leaving at positive because it is source. See, but now this fellow, this R1 is there, right? This fellow will enter at plus and leave at minus. Current always go like this. So it happens to go this way. Alright. So therefore it is, you see, V, this is V2, current entering at negative, leaving at positive here through V2. So V2, now again, current always enter at plus, leave at minus for this passive components like this, whatever. So see, I'm going from minus to plus, achieving something. So therefore positive V. I'm going from plus to minus, losing something, say minus R2 into I. So minus R2 into I minus this Vx equal to 0. So therefore Vx is equal to V minus R2 into I. Okay, so potential difference across this combination Vx is equal to, we have V minus R2 into I. But what is given to us Vx? So he gave Vx equal to 0. So therefore V minus R2 into I is equal to 0. This corresponds to what? V is equal to R2 into I. That's it. So V is equal to R2 into I, or V or V2, both are same, is equal to R2 into I. Okay. Now, with this, what can be done? So with this, we can, let me take another sheet. With this, what can be done? So, readily, what do you have? Readily, we have this. As of now, we found V is equal to R2 multiplied by I. Now, from this circuit, what is current I? So, it is simple, right? So, these components are in series. So, I is equal to what? Potential difference by passive component in this case, that is ri is equal to say v by r. So therefore we get like this, I is equal to, so what voltages you have, v1 and v2, you take their sum, so you get you get what now, just take their sum, v1 plus v2. Now v1 plus v2, or we could say 2v, because v1 is equal to v2 is equal to v, or we can take 2v, but let me put it down like this, v1 plus v2 by r1 plus r2, see, by this r1 plus r2 plus r, right? So r1 plus r2 plus r, so v1 is equal to v2 is equal to v, so therefore this is 2v by r1 plus r2 plus r. Now from this you have v is equal to r2i, and from this we have I is equal to 2v by this. So now what do you do? So you plug in this I, you plug in this I here, so this corresponds to this, v is equal to r2 multiplied by 2v divided by r1 plus r2 plus r. Alright, so these two are cancelled out. So now what do you have? R1 plus r2 plus r is equal to 2r2. Alright, so from this what is r now? R is equal to r2 minus r1. That's it. It is very simple, right? There is no big deal in this. So he is asking this, if the potential difference across source having resistance R2 as internal quantity equal to zero, then he is asking what is this R? So this fellow R is R2 minus R1. Yeah, if you want to take a snap, you can just take it. Phase 1. Okay, this is phase 1. And this is phase 2. Alright, so that's it for today. Thank you. See, before, so what do? You have ideals. See, you have ideal quantity here, and this is practical quantity. See, whenever you have a voltage source, so whenever I have a voltage source like this, internal resistance of a voltage source must always come in series. Okay. And this is my voltage source. See, this is my Vx. Okay, this is my Rx. Or this is a Vs, source voltage, source resistance. Okay. Now, whenever I have a practical current source, so I must take internal resistance of this current source as in shunt or in parallel like this. This is my source current. This is my source resistance. Now, ideally, what happens is that R is equal to infinity. Ideally, in this case, R is equal to 0. So, therefore, ideally, R is equal to 0. This fellow must be infinity. If R is equal to 0, then what happens? There will be no drop across RS. So, whatever energy he is going to deliver, that will go to the network. Okay. So, that's it. So, anyways, we have lectures on these things in detail to understand about various problems and beautiful concepts of this circuit theory or circuit analysis, whatever. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you.